Dr. Bart Rademacher, and this is Prescription for Your Transformation, Real People, Real Conversations, and Real Success. And this is part two, talking to the super connector, Stephen Klein. And I really love connecting with Stephen because he's that guy that's out there in the continuous search for the things that will optimize his health. You know, all the technologies, the gadgets, you know, the processes or the systems out there that will truly make a difference in your life. And so once again, really excited to be talking to Stephen in part two with him, the super connector, talking about biohacking and optimizing health. And this is a new kind of terrain that's been developing over the last, I think, you know, 10 or 15 years. It's followed up from the wellness revolution that people started back in the late 80s, early 90s, and really gotten underway in the early 2000s. Biohacking is a very specific field, and it really is all about finding that shortcut that will help you optimize your health, help with your performance, help with your focus, help with your weight, you know, all these different things. And it's understanding, you know, how our biological systems actually work together. And this is something doctors and medicine aren't looking into, and how to supercharge those good processes, get rid of the bad processes so that you can enhance. I mean, just think of it this way. I mean, biohacking is no different than this metaphor, this example that I'm going to give you, right? If you're tired, what do? You drink coffee, right? If you feel stiff, what do? Yoga. If you're anxious, what do? It's meditation. And you know what? If you want to build muscle and then improve your performance, what do? Exercise. All of that, that's biohacking. And so love to hear some of your experiences, Stephen, some of your thoughts, your perspectives as a layman, but also expert in the biohacking field, because you've been around them for quite some time.
Yeah, thanks, Dr. Bart. I'll share kind of what motivated me to get into all this, if that's okay. So as you know, I got hit by a car going the wrong way on the interstate, you know, 19 years ago now, October 6th. And I had like 8 months of just really intense rehab where I couldn't do anything really. So I was 35 years old. And at that point, I figured I had this you know, fear of missing out type thing. I felt like my life had been chopped in half. So I'd already been really into health, parts of it, not holistic health, but nutrition and exercise. So when I had my recovery, I was like, I've got to figure out and learn how to live longer with more vitality to make up for this lost time. Probably not the healthiest, you know, perception on things at the time or perspective, but it served me really well because as time went on, I had my radar up for anything that would come at me that was going to give me vitality, longevity, you know, optimal health. And so my first experience with that was probably brain entrainment when I discovered the new reality device and then brain tap, and you've probably heard of those, kind of sync the hemispheres of your brain and help you get into a meditative state. So that was kind of new to me. I wasn't a big meditation guy. But it was in 2014, a friend of mine had sent me a link to the Bulletproof Executive, which is Dave Asprey's site. Dave Asprey's the gentleman that actually coined the term biohacking. Of course, people had been doing biohacking for years and years and years, but he's the one that coined that term, got it in the dictionary. You know, he was a techie nerd. He was already hacking computers. And then he thought, okay, I'll hack my body, biohacking. So there you go. But I get that link. I start following, you know, kind of the things that he teaches and some of these modalities. And then, you know, you being a big Tony Robbins person, I was at an Unleash the Power Within in like 2012 or 2013. And the last day of that event is all about health. But at the time, Tony wasn't exactly on the same page as me as far as what that meant. So I was walking around the facility, ran into this guy named John Jaquish, who owned a company called Biodensity, this amazing machine that reverses osteoporosis. You can say that, clinically proven. He's probably the top guy in osteogenesis or bone growth in the world. So I spent like 3 hours with him, and I was sure at the time that I was going to introduce this guy to somebody that would help things blow up. So fast forward to January 2015, I messaged Dave Asprey on Facebook Messenger back when he's answering his own social media. I'm like, hey, I got this great biohacking device, this Biodensity you should look at. He's okay, I can set up a call with my secretary. They talk, John Jaquish and Dave Asprey, goes really well. Dave flies him out to Vancouver to hear all about it more. They spend a whole day together. Then John Jaquish calls me and says, hey, Stephen, Dave Asprey wants me to be at the biohacking conference in Pasadena in September, but I can't go. He was the keynote speaker at the biggest osteoporosis conference in the world in Milan, Italy. Tony Robbins had a UPW in LA where he had to have all these people there for 7,000 people at the time. That was a lot. So he says to me, hey, Steven, I'll give you 5 tickets to this conference if you and your friends will spend an hour in the booth with my guy with the biodensity. So that was how I got to the conference for the first year. And I've been every year. As a matter of fact, 2016, I was fortunate enough to camp with Dave Asprey and Camp Biohack at Burning Man. Saw you there the following year. But my whole connector thing, how I love to put people together and enhance people's growth but through connections, went into hyperdrive at that point. And so I started to learn about what all those modalities were that are out there, what works better with what as far as stacking. And that's where I really just ignited into the whole world of biohacking at a really high level from really just being introduced to a website and Dave Asprey in the beginning. So it's been really, really exciting. I love the tribe and the people that are involved in this that really seem to want to help people without an agenda, which is really rare to find in the world. And at the same time, most of these modalities are really helpful for people, aren't things that cause side effects or have chemicals or anything like that. If anything, they're looking to remove all of that and get us back to how we were before we messed the earth up with toxins and that kind of thing. So it's an exciting space. I know I went off kind of on that ramble, but I get really, really excited about talking about this biohacking stuff and where it's headed and how many friends and contacts I now have in this space.
I mean, what's not to get excited about? I mean, if you're thinking about optimizing health, increasing performance, increasing focus, improving your memory, improving your sleep, improving basically every aspect of your life, you know, what's not to want from that? You know, one of the things that I think is a challenge is that, you know, many of the scientific communities are delegitimizing, you know, biohacking. And they do that out of their own ignorance. And I get it. As scientists, you know, you want to spend years on the benches, you know, the lab benches, you know, trying to prove all sorts of things. But here's the truth about biohacking. I mean, do you really want to wait 10, 20 years before you find out what's actually going to help you optimize your health? And so putting in perspective, I think, is important, what biohacking really is. I mean, it is evidence and science-based sort of hacks, if you will. I mean, processes that will help you optimize. And let's take the easiest one and perhaps the most important one to think about is this. It's our sleep. You know, every animal, every insect, insects too, by the way, require sleep. Why? It's our time for recovery. So if you don't sleep well, and science has already proven this, you know, it's the cause, or it's one of the underlying causes of all these chronic diseases, including cancer, heart disease, obesity, diabetes, all that kind of stuff. So it behooves you, right, really, to improve your sleep. Bad sleep, you know, higher risk of making mistakes, poor memory, all these different things. So how do you hack the sleep? Well, melatonin is one. You know, going for a walk outside, you know, for 30 minutes in the sun is another one. And that's, you know, for more later. And making sure that you're not exposed to blue light. I mean, these are what we call biohacking. And so there's nothing weird about it. You're probably doing a lot of these things already. So my question for you then, you know, Steve, is, you know, how do you talk to people, you know, about biohacking? I mean, is it just your personal story and they see your excitement and then you tell them all the different things that you can do? Or you know, I know that you're also on this plan to have your own podcast series about biohacking. I mean, what's your plan to help people appreciate and take a look outside of what's traditional?
So one of the main things is to be an example of this. So I'm 53 years old and people ask me all the time, no way, you're 53. What do you do? Fortunately, some of the best biohacks are free, whether it's breathing exercises, Wim Hof breathing, pranayama, breathology, something like that. You mentioned part of one, being outside in the sun and people and educate people that there are different benefits of different types of day in the sun. Early morning sun, like the first 30 minutes of sunrise, there's no vitamin D that you're going to process from that because there's no UV light, but the early morning sun is really, really, really great for your circadian rhythms, your vision, healing skin. If you had a sunburn, you should go out in the early morning sun, and 30 minutes before sunset will help you a ton. So there's benefits of that. Grounding, like we cut ourselves off from the earth and now almost everybody's inflamed because we're wearing shoes, walking on carpeting, cement, whatever, instead of coming in contact with water or the natural earth surface where we get those negative ions. So that's free. The breathing is free. there's a lot of things you can do as far as sleep, like you said, that don't cost you any money. Now, that said, there are a ton of biohacks, most of which are meant to put your body in a state back before we mess it up again, whether it's red light therapy, which is going to mimic a lot of what the sun does, infrared saunas to detoxify yourself. There are resistance training machines that will give you incredible outcomes versus what you would do normally. There's that Carol bike that we talked about that will increase your VO2 max by 12% in 9 weeks. So there are things in biohacking where a lot of people do things haphazardly and you don't really know what's happening, even though you may get some results, but you can test and measure almost everything now. So when I talk to people about biohacking, normally we'll get into something that can improve their life without spending a lot of money first and some of these things that they're not doing in their daily routine. And then they'll ask specifically about certain areas and I'll go, okay, well, you may want to look at this, or you may want to look at this, because there's so many things out there. And I've been exposed to most, at least the ones that I'm really excited about that have been vetted. And my friends that are deep divers have studied them and I know they're great things. So I'm kind of like that hub of trusted resource where I can recommend things to people, but I love it. And I love seeing people's lives change for the better, even if it's just one thing they implement that they weren't doing. So it's not too hard to have that conversation as long as somebody's open to it and they want to change. Now, most of my friends aren't walking around smoking cigarettes and going to raves till 3 a.m. either. So,
Well, I'm really looking forward to your podcast series because, you know, it's all about, you know, finding that trusted source. And, you know, you're doing all your investigative work and talking to all the right people to really appreciate, you know, all these different things. And, you know, besides like infrared, you know, those pulse infrared saunas, you've got cryotherapy, you've got isolation tanks, you've got ozone therapy. And interesting, and I catch myself with this as well, because as much as I've been, you know, trained in traditional medicine, you know, I still look outside of the box all the time. But sometimes I just get caught off guard. And for example, my first response to ozone therapy, what is that really going to do, right? And so that's the tendency of most people, because we're just not exposed enough to this concept of biohacking. And it's a beautiful concept, because really what it is doing, it's not only addressing the potential causes that could harm the body long term, but it's also reversing them, you know, any of the problems or imbalance that you have, and actually supercharging you. And there's this concept of biohacking becoming superhuman. And so, well, why not, right? Why not live, you know, have a quality of life with tremendous energy and vitality till you're 100, 150, or even 180, you know, and this whole concept of, you know, we need to age, you know, we will age and let's just get used to it. I mean, it's ridiculous. And unfortunately, too many docs who don't understand or don't have a solution for the patient, they just throw up their hands and say, you know what, you're just getting old. And I can say that because I'm a doctor and I've heard it many, many times. My approach is always, okay, what else can we look for? Because, you know, we do have the blueprint of the perfect functioning body. And when we get that awareness of what we're actually doing to it, that's harming it, you know, we can also start looking at changing that, but also find ways to really optimize. But one of the things, and I want to share this right now, and then in a moment, I'm just going to have you wrap it up, is that all this is basically self-experimentation. You know, always check with the doctor, you know, whatever it is that you're doing, make sure that, you know, it's safe. And, but you have to measure stuff. You can't just start taking supplements and hoping it's going to work. And I think this is the biggest danger out there, that people just start doing things and it's perhaps even the wrong thing to do. And so that's where we look at, you know, our epigenetics. So we look at gene mapping. We look at all the biometrics and bioanalytics, and I'd love to have a conversation with you on another time. And I'm also putting together all sorts of lab panels. And that's a great, great starting point. But what else would you want people to know, you know, going into biohacking? You know, where are some of the places they can go to besides you? What else can they be doing?
I mean, I'll mention some people to follow. Certainly Dave Asprey, if you go to bulletproof.com. Ben Greenfield is a really big name now in this space. Mark Sisson. And even look at some events to go to. There's a really cool event called Paleo FX coming up April 29th to May 1st in Austin, Texas, that you want to kick the tires and play on all this stuff. Literally, there's tech halls with all these amazing devices you can go use and play with. You want to get a little more of an exotic trip, there's a health optimization summit in London, England at the end of May. So you can just Google that, health optimization summit, London. All these are 2022. You can look up the Biohacking Congress, which is doing smaller events regionally around the country that are really cool. Those are probably the best resources that I would give. Of course, on superconnector.com, I'll have a site and podcast. I'll have some cool things listed there. I'll have a link tree of the different products that I recommend that I think are really, really cool. Most of which will have some kind of coupon code. And you'll see alternative sources for things similar, but they're not ones that I use or that I have an affiliate code for as well. But it's just fun. I mean, Dr. Bart, when I look ultimately what I'm trying to do, it's not, you know, because people sometimes get caught up in the wrong thing that, oh, you want to try to be 150, that's impossible. Well, how about this? You just live with vitality and energy pain-free until you die in your sleep or very peacefully, instead of the way, unfortunately, most Americans are dying. In misery and pain for weeks, months, if not years, yep. Taking prescription pills along the way.
Yep. No, well said. And on that note, you know, it's incumbent on us listening, you know, to this podcast is to start looking into, you know, how is it that we can optimize our health and reaching out to people like Steve Klein and on his website, superconnector.com, but it's spelled S-U-P-E-R with a K-O-N-N-E-C-T-O-R. So a little different than you might expect, but I love the way that you spell it because it makes you that unique.
And my initials, S-K.
S-K. Stephen, thank you so much. And this ends, you know, part two of our series of part three with a super connector, and we will be back.
Thanks for joining us on another episode of Dr. Rademacher's Prescription for Your Transformation. Continue the path towards discovering your own authentic genius by tuning in next time for more real conversations with real people.